What is going on, everyone? Welcome to the vlog. Today we are here in Vancouver, Canada. Steph and I just came here for a couple days. We wanted to hang out with my brother, who's actually behind the camera today. And also, low-key, Steph and I are kind of considering moving here in the next year or so. I love living in Kelowna, but there's just something about the city that I think I might like just a little bit more. So anyway, we're staying here at a nice Airbnb downtown. I'll give you guys a super quick little tour of the main area here. So here we've got the kitchen. Then over here, I feel like really from all directions, you have just an amazing view of the mountains and the skyline. And then out here on the deck, I feel like this is where you get the best view. And this is just one of the things that I love about Vancouver. It kind of reminds me of Hong Kong in the sense that you get a beautiful view of the mountains and the harbor. And then right over here, you still have this beautiful skyline. Today we're gonna be going for a push workout. So it's gonna be the second push workout in the week for me. And this is one that I haven't shown on the channel yet. But anyway, really looking forward to getting a training session in over there. But first, we've gotta go for a pre-workout meal. So we're gonna be going to a really popular vegan joint here. It's called Virtuous Pie. And a bunch of people recommended that to Steph. And I feel like I should say, I've had a ton of people ask me, Jeff, are you planning to go vegan or are you going vegan? Because I've been using more vegan foods in my diet and like vegan protein powder. And I don't actually have any plans to go vegan anytime in the near future, but I do like trying different types of foods. And I do have a lot of respect for the vegan lifestyle from an ethical perspective. So I have been making more vegan choices lately, but also I feel like a lot of people are under the impression that vegan foods don't taste good. But honestly, that couldn't be further from the truth in my recent experience. Over in Hong Kong, a few of our best meals were from vegan restaurants. So anyway, we're gonna go check out that spot and I'll show you guys what I get. I bite my tongue but can't change how I think. I talk to you because I can't afford a shrink. Okay, so guys, we just finished up eating at Virtuous Pie. It was super busy in there. Apparently this is like the best vegan place in Vancouver to get pizza and ice cream. So I had their pizza. This was my second time trying vegan pizza. The first time I didn't like it at all. It was something my brother liked. This time it was a little bit better. I got like a mushroom type pizza. But for me, the weirdest part is always the cheese. It's like a nut based cheese and it just doesn't really taste like real cheese to me. So it was okay. Like I ate half of it. It was pretty good, but it wasn't like, it didn't blow me away by any means. Steph had another pizza that I felt like was actually probably a little bit better.
I thought mine was delicious.
And hers was a little bit better, but still, I feel like if there's one thing the vegans haven't figured out yet, in my opinion, it's the pizza. But anyway, I got some vegan ice cream here. So this is a vanilla vanilla vegan ice cream. I don't know what the base is.
They figured out ice cream.
That is super good. That's like some of the best ice cream I've ever had.
They have ice cream technology, but their pizza technology.
It's so good.
No, maybe it's just the cheese that they haven't figured out yet.
Yeah.
I think
it's the cashew cheese. It was a weird flavor. That's pretty good.
It tastes like coconut. It's coconut based.
Oh, is it?
I thought it was coconut flavor.
I love coconut, so that makes sense. That's so good. Definitely, definitely recommend the ice cream. So.
That's good.
I'm gonna grab some pre-workout. We're gonna head over to West Coast Iron Gym. Check with you guys over there. I was talking to Ron about it.
Yeah, we've already discussed, so you're all good to go.
Whenever I'm at a spot like this that has all kinds of really cool, interesting equipment, I like to switch it up a little bit, so I might veer outside my scheduled program just a touch. But we're gonna stick with the same basic core. So we're on week 8, day 5, which is the second push day here. And we're gonna be kicking it off with close grip bench press. I've got 3 sets of 8 at 80% of my 1 rep max. That's actually gonna be really, really heavy today. For me personally, when I set up my bench, I don't like to use too close of a grip. So on my normal powerlifting style days, I'll bench with a really wide grip out here, really powerlifting style with a big arch. Then when I'm benching on my close grip days, I tend to bring that in quite a bit, but I'm still not in like 1 time shoulder width. I'm probably more like 1.5 times shoulder width. So you'll see that when I set up here now. But yeah, I'm gonna do a couple warm-up sets and then we'll jump into it. And we're gonna auto-regulate this today, see how the weight feels and go from there. So here we go. I figured it's also worth mentioning the difference between the wide grip bench and the close grip bench here. With the wide grip, you've got a really reduced range of motion, whereas with this, we're getting a lot more range of motion, which is probably a lot better for hypertrophy. And then also, the closer grip, we'll get more shoulder flexion involved, So you're going to target a little bit more of the upper pec, which is good. It's good to have that balance of movements. And then also, if you have any weak point in your bench press, I feel like a close grip press, including that in your routine, can really help you break through some sticking points. So there's three for three. In my last push day video, I talked about all my training gear. So I'll link that in the description if you'd like to check it out. Light today. I'm not gonna back down. I know it's gonna be heavy for me today. But I'm gonna try it and then base my subsequent sets off of how this goes. And I'm just doing tap and go here. I'm not gonna pause because the set will go on forever. All right, here we go. I'm gonna get set up off the bench.
Two, three, here we go. Let's go. Let's go. Come on, Jeff.
It's pretty good, actually. Thanks, man.
Nice set, man.
Yeah, thank you. That felt pretty good. Let me know if you saw anything wrong with that. I feel like my butt might have popped up a tiny bit on a couple of reps there, but that feels good. I think I'm going to leave it where it is. I don't know if I'd call this a true close grip bench press. It's something kind of more in between. But when I'm benching with a powerlifting grip, I'm way out here. It's so good training in an environment like this. It's like, we got chalk over here. Tons of people here who are serious about lifting. I feel like this is becoming the Canadian Mecca of bodybuilding. If you're ever on the West Coast, I definitely recommend coming and checking it out. It's a really cool spot, super motivated. One, two, three,
come on. Nice. Push.
One more.
Push.
Okay. Woo. Oh, man. All right. That's it. That was pretty good. Thanks. Up next, we've got standing overhead barbell press. I was hoping they'd have some kind of cool shoulder machine here, but everything they've got here I've tried before, so we're just going to stick with the basics, do some OHP, and after that, we're going to move on to some more fun stuff. So here we're doing three sets, six reps. I'm gonna start with my first set, just 115, and then I'm gonna go up to 135 from there. I might throw an extra set on depending on how this goes and how it feels today. Sometimes when I'm on the road, it's like the weights can feel super inconsistent, so I really do try to auto-regulate. But yeah, we'll see how this is feeling today. Until after two reps, that's gonna be too light. Didn't have a groove on that one. My OHP is just totally out of proportion with my bench press. I don't know if it's a technique thing or a anthropometry thing. My delts seem to be fine, so I'm not too worried about it, but I wish I had that Matt Ogus press. While we're here, I figured check out see what the lighting's like. Got an incline dumbbell press. This is an Arsenal strength incline bench. I've never tried this piece of equipment in my life. It looks really interesting because it's got two different adjustment spots down here. So I guess you can like account for any kind of curvature in your lower back. But I'm gonna give this a try it feels really different. It almost feels like I'd have less of an incline because I'm more back on the bench like this. The bench is actually a little more flat up here. But I still want to try it out because it feels really cool. Here we go. Oh man, that's so nice. All right, so guys, all we got left now for the rest of the workout is isolation stuff. So up first for the chest, we're gonna have the pec deck. Here, I like to think about driving my elbows towards one another, and I like to experiment with different variations, see what works best for you, basically. After that, we've got a lean away cable lateral raise, 4 sets of 8, so a little bit heavier than usual. I actually like to slow down the tempo on these, go a little bit heavier, and don't let yourself come to a passive position at the bottom. Always keep your arms slightly out from your body, and that'll help you keep a little bit more of a constant tension on your lateral delt, which may not be beneficial from a hypertrophy perspective, but for me, it does help me reach failure a little bit better, and also gives me a little bit more of a pump, so nothing wrong with that. After that, we're moving on to a cable tricep kickback. The way I've been doing these lately is bilaterally, so I'll do both arms at once and kind of cross two cables over and then extend out while being really bent over at the hips. If you guys have never tried them this way, definitely recommend giving them a shot. You save time, basically you get to do both arms at once. I find it to be a really comfortable position, and I find it's a variation not a lot of people have tried, and the tension curve on the cables is going to be so much better than with a dumbbell. So when it comes to a kickback, this is the way I like to do them. And then we're going to be finishing off with a bicycle crunch. So here you kind of get a lot of bang for your buck when it comes to an ab movement, where you're gonna be bringing your upper body down toward your toes, and then you're also bringing your toes up toward your upper body. So you've kind of got like a combo of a regular crunch and a leg raise all in one. And then you also have some rotation from side to side, so you're really gonna hit the obliques and the TVA as well. So that's a great ab movement. So I'm gonna put in my headphones, get in the zone, finish the rest of this workout, and I'll check in with you guys after we're done. All right, everyone, that's a wrap for the workout and for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Hopefully it wasn't too loud in there. If you did like the video, don't forget to leave me a thumbs up. Also, as usual, I'll have all of my gear and training apparel linked in the description box below. I know Rise is doing a huge Black Friday sale. I'm not actually sure when that is, but stay tuned for that. Don't forget to subscribe if you happen to be new to the channel, and I'll see you guys all here in the next video.